Thank you. tonight's ceremony is especially meaningful to me personally, as the last of our four daughters will be graduated from Villa this evening. Having been blessed with four girls has made me acutely aware of the rewards and challenges that today's young women face. As a member of the board, I've also been compelled to reflect more actively on the role that Villa has played in the development of these graduates, the ideas that remain with them, and the paths that they will take. This is a time of great excitement for young women. Opportunities are opening up for them as never before. The differences in colleges alone between my generation and that of this graduating class are enormous. Many of the schools to which these girls have applied were not even accepting women when I was growing up. Career decisions are much more complicated and challenging than they were 30 years ago, believe me. For myself, having majored in motherhood and minored in nursing, I would like to start this evening with just a few thoughts from a mother's point of view. To begin with, let me say that although women's rights are being advocated, as well they should, I would hope that you will never let feminism get in the way of humanism. By this I mean that expression of feminine rights should be done with the needs of our total society in mind, and most importantly, the needs of your own family. Along with this, I would like to say that the decision of your choice of career is not nearly as important as the manner in which you carry out that choice. I hope, having graduated from Villa, you will look back and remember the name of your school as an acronym for five important attributes: vitality, interest, love, loyalty, and action. These attributes will help you in any job you choose. Firstly, vitality and energy put into any job will generate enthusiasm in others to do good work, getting it done faster and better. Interest in others makes each of us a more interesting person. Nothing is quite so boring as a person who is only self-interested. Love is the greatest gift we can give another. Freely and generously given, it will be returned 100-fold. Loyalty, be loyal to those who have stood by you, your family, friends, your church, school, country, but most of all, the ideals that you have learned to value. Action, actively pursue the privilege to do good works. Don't be a fence sitter waiting for someone else to volunteer. You set the example, whether it be to work for the church, community, or just helping an elderly grandmother. Vitality, interest, love, loyalty, action, Villa. With these few thoughts in mind, let us begin tonight's celebration.
And if living for myself is This year's graduating class has selected two of its members to address us at this time. This evening's commencement speakers will be the outstanding honor graduate, Carolyn Maxwell, and honor graduate and the class speaker, Kathleen Shibetta.
Good evening, Bishop Murphy, administration, faculty, members of the Board of Trustees, alumni, family, guests, and graduates. We gather tonight united as a class with a special happiness and yet a special sadness. Now that the time we have waited and worked for, counted the days to, has finally arrived, we look back and see the value in the struggle of our high school years. As we depart, excited and challenged by the new experiences ahead, we take time to thank those who have given us the foundation for our growth. Like vines, firm and strong, our class has become entwined as one. Our education and maturation at Villa Maria Academy will provide us the means to branch to greater heights, heights we never could have reached without the gentle nurturing of the Villa family. Our primary thanks must go to our parents and family members. The guidance, love, understanding, and patience you have bestowed upon us cannot go unmentioned. Thank you so much for that unfaltering support, which has been a determining factor in our success. You have helped us through four major years in our lives. We are grateful to you for everything you have shared with us, including the most precious gifts of your love and time. The Villa faculty and administration is also deserving of great thanks. It is difficult to isolate one lone area in which your strengths have become ours. We have learned so much from you, Of course, we are grateful for your excellent academic instruction, but your teachings go even farther than that. We are also appreciative of the examples you set in your everyday lives. You have encouraged us to strive for the best, and strive we now shall. Thank you for giving of yourselves. Finally, I think our friends, graduates and non-graduates, should realize how much they
have meant to us.
True friends are very rare, and during our trying moments, their true colors have shown through. We thank them for always being there, for their support, and for their love. The time has come for us to leave the security of being part of the vine, these people who mean so much to us. To our parents, the roots of the vine, we thank you for your love. To the faculty who has fed and nurtured the vine, we thank you for your time. And to the graduates, the new cuttings of the vine, thank you for being yourselves. We, the many cuttings of the class of 1985, are going out on our own to form new roots. We are going off in different directions, yet shall always be one because of the memories we share. We, the graduating class of 1985, are ready to take on the world. We find it hard to thank all those who have helped and supported us along the way, and even harder to say goodbye. We will not forget the places from which we came, or the people to whom we owe so much. Thank you for our past at Villa, and thank you for our future. Faculty, family, and friends, if we can take with us half of what you have shared, happiness in life is possible. Thank you for giving us the foundations from which to climb to further heights.
Good evening, Bishop Murphy, administration, faculty, mom and members of the Board of Trustees, alumna, family, guests, and graduates. It is my great honor this evening to speak on behalf of the graduating class of 1985. These past 4 years have been for me, as I'm sure they have been for each graduate, a very special and important part of my life. They have been challenging, exciting, memorable, and not always easy, but usually pleasant. Certainly they have been rewarding. Perhaps the most rewarding aspect of all is that during my years at Villa, I've grown a great deal. At least spiritually, not physically. I've had the opportunity to witness a complete blossoming of myself and my classmates from schoolgirls into young adults. If one looks back, it is easy to recall freshman year. It seems like just yesterday, we were tripping up the stairs and clogging the hallways. Well, for some of us, it was just yesterday. But it used to be that a class of 174 seemed gargantuan, that there were too many names to remember, too many faces to recognize. Slowly, we became familiar with each other and stopped embarrassing ourselves by addressing our friends with the wrong names.
We also did our part
in upholding those fine freshman traditions, such as losing sports day. Sophomore year, we began to gain confidence. We all rejoiced at the opportunity to exploit the incoming freshmen. But the nice part was that in addition to seniority, we had firmly integrated ourselves into the Villa family. We had developed new talents and friendships. Our roots were secure. Junior year presented new challenges and privileges. We were now upperclassmen, or rather upperclass women, and prepared ourselves for leading the school. We enjoyed ring ceremony and the opportunity to attend the Christmas formal dance, which doesn't necessarily mean that we had the opportunity to get dates. But as the seniors ahead of us counted their days, we secretly counted them too, contemplating the day when we ourselves would rule the school. Metaphorically, of course. Finally, senior year arrived, and with it, undisputed respect. Because the rest of the school had new uniforms, our old heather blues, once looked down upon as rags, became unique, a novelty, the unquestioned mark of prestige. We hope that as seniors, we have lived up to these responsibilities given us. Now high school has ended. It is time to branch out. But first, a few words to the graduates to remember the good times. Remember always, stop, drop, and roll. Beaver, Amanie, Amguso, Saba. Moby, the cell down. Word association, 7-Up, never had it, never will. The Last Hurrah, the book and prom, trips to France, Italy, and Spain, Mice Tree, Jenny Pride, Argent Nuit, and Friends Forever. As freshmen, we came to Villa, budding with enthusiasm and curiosity, and perhaps a little fear. We became part of the school, sprouting new interests and new friendships. We grew to be close, to understand one another. We nurtured among us all a common bond of loyalty, camaraderie, and trust. We grew to be unified, to be complete, until like leaves on a vine, we became deeply and thoroughly intertwined. Now the class of 85 would never be complete without each and every one of its 174 members. And now, a final goodbye. To our parents, thank you for your guidance and support these past 4 years. To our teachers, thank you for your patience and for your gift of knowledge. To the graduates, thank you for your individual contributions, for your smiles, for your support, for the times we laughed together, many though they were. Remember that like leaves on a vine, we may grow apart, but we will always have the common bond of family formed during our time together at the Villa. And now a final question to the graduates of 1985. How do you feel? And our inevitable response to the rest of the world. We feel good. Oh, we feel so good. Thank you.
Presidential Academic Fitness Awards will be made to graduating seniors who have met the following criteria. Attained a B-plus average or equivalent, accumulated over grades 9, 10, and 11, and the first semester of grade 12. Received a score in the 11th or 12th grade, placing them at or above the 80th percentile on any nationally recognized standardized achievement test, or any nationally standardized college admissions examination, and completed by graduation at least 12 high school or higher level course units in the new basics. The National Commission on Excellence in Education recommended these courses to include English, mathematics, science, social studies, foreign languages, and computer science. I would ask that you please hold your applause until the reception of diplomas is completed. His Excellency, Most Reverend Michael J. Murphy, now presents the following diplomas to the graduating class of 1985. Carolyn Marie Maxwell, Outstanding Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $5,935 from Allegheny College Grant, $1,900 Allegheny Scholars Award, $1,000 Wolves Club Scholarship, and $50 bond from the Kiwanis Club for Academic Excellence. Kathleen Ann Shibetta, Honor Graduate, $50 bond from the Kiwanis Club for Academic Excellence Award. Leanne Catherine Wenzel, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Anne Marie Montgomery,
Honor Graduate,
National Merit Finalist. Jean Marie Rozmodowski, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Denise Marie Hall, Honor Graduate, $2,000 President's Award, $1,000 American Values Scholarship. Michelle Christine Tottleben, Honor Graduate, $2,000 Merit Scholarship, University of Pittsburgh. Laura Elizabeth Schmidt, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Heidi Ann Hewitt, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $2,000 University Scholarship, University of Pittsburgh. Suzanne Marie Gora, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $1,500 Academic Grant, Gannon University. Heather Ann Allshaus, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Pamela Marie Soule, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Lori Ann Coleman, Honor Graduate, $3,250 Marquette University Academic Scholarship. Anne Marie Weibel, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Deborah Marie Hellman, Honor Graduate, $1,200
Academic Grant, Gannon University,
$500 at Kennedy Eckerd, Gannon University. Anne Marie Zomsik, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Catherine Ann Wingeter, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Kimberly Ann Klecker, Honor Graduate, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Grace Jean Lukowski, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Kathleen Ann Murphy, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $2,000 grant, John Carroll University. Deborah Marie
Mishler.
Mary Evelyn Mead,
Presidential Academic Fitness Award.
Darlene Marie Valhovic, Presidential Academic Fitness Award.
Brenda Jacqueline Vargo, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $3,000 Academic Scholarship, University of.
Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Amy R. Deckard. Jesse Ann Simon,
Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Lisa Ann Heberlein,
Presidential Academic Fitness Award.
Lisa Marie Brockler, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Gabrielle Maria Bogdansky. Susan Marie Hines, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Linda Marie Altadonna. Beth Ann Kennedy, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Barbara Eleanor Smith, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Denise Marie Majeski. Lisa Maria Zaroli. Roseanne Danielle Greiger, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Linda Mae Thomas, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Michelle Marie Rovnek. Sarah Ellen Vicky. Robin Ann Pohl, $1,000 E.R. Barron Trust Fund Scholarship. Deborah Ann Thompson, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Daria Joanne Kuzman. Rosemary Margaret Campbell. Christine Marie Plum. Crystal Celeste Johnson. Leslie Ann Gelcher, $2,500 Freshman Academic Scholarship, Marymount College of Virginia. Shelby Andrea Franzelia, $200 President Award, Temple University, $3,550 Scholarship, Temple University. Kathleen Ann Wechner, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Malini Negi. Kimberly Ann Campaign. Julie Ann McCallion. Megan Frances Gerber. Adrian Elizabeth Ashby. Carrie Michelle Mastrian. Suzanne Marie Angela Dandria. Eileen Marie Buzik. Carol Lynn Garbarino, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $3,600 Allegheny College Grant. Jennifer Marion Allison Hendrick. Margaret Mary Jenko. Rosina Bucarelli. Kathleen Geary. Carol Ann Hull. Jennifer Louise Engert, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Jill Deanna Larson, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Denise Ann McCaleb. Suzanne Sennett Smith. Deborah Ann Abate. Karen Bridget Yadeski. Thank you. Holly Carol Fisk. Marjorie Lynn Ruland. Mary Elizabeth Hilbrick, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Natalie Louise Fatica. Amy Louise Elizabeth Calabrese, $500 University Grant, Gannon University. Sheila Marie Houghton. Laura Elizabeth Schultz, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Michelle Marie Makalevich. Susan Marie Neumeyer, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Marlene Ann Rowan. Darlene Ann Rowan. Shelley Marie Fetzner, $3,000 Athletic Scholarship Grant, Gannon University. Susan Marie DeLuca, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Carrie Claire Torella. Susan Marie Majerski, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Christina Marie Ward, $1,000 Smith Erie Credit Union Scholarship. Diane Marie Gray, $500 Villa Maria Scholar College. Paula Sue Zalaski. Denise Marie McGraw. Tammy Germaine Lori. Heidi Christine Decker, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Margaret Mary Wolfe. Kimberly Ann Scozzi, $400 Academic Grant, Gannon University, $600 Kennedy Eckerd, Gannon University. Tracy Lynn Personia, $600 scholarship, Gannon University. Suzanne Lynn Reiser. Susan Marie Bayhurst. Denise Ann Farver. Julie Ann Dill, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Margot Lynn Munch. Erin Kathleen Bose. Patricia Ann Cray, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $1,800 Academic Grant, University of Maryland. Melinda Walsh Murphy. Elizabeth Ann Mancuso, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Carolyn Ann Binzeil. Catherine Ann Rogers, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Christine Mary Rado. Julia Jean Clan. Elizabeth Ann Keller Zeitler, $1,000 Presidential Scholarship, Dartmouth College. Melissa Ann Michael, National Merit Finalist. Susan Marie Bloss. Amy Ann Caverman, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $1,500 Merwin Scholarship, $1,000 Garfield Scholarship, Hiram College, $3,000 Hiram College Scholarship. Jill Califf Pontiff. Julie Marie Bennett. Pamela Ann Myers, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Kelly Jean Wallace, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Stephanie Ann Bolash. Mary Margaret Baker. Sabrina Ann Hessinger, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Tina Marie Scott. Mary Angela Toll. Christine Ann Miller, $500 Art Scholarship, Mercyhurst College, $500 Presidential Scholarship, Mercyhurst College. Jill Marie Reisenweber, $1,740 one-half tuition scholarship from J.H. Thompson. Susan Catherine Preston, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Jill Michelle Desser. Susan Marie Brueger, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Jennifer Ann Beck, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Bernice Omer. Marie-Pierre Anne-Sophie Duvivier. Marie-Pierre is receiving a certificate of achievement for completing 1 year as a foreign exchange student. Sarah Ann Flaherty. Susan Leslie Twiss. Patricia Ann Filipkowski. Ellen Margaret Westoff, $3,000 academic grant, Washington and Jefferson College. Nora Jean Therese Lillis. Carrie Ann Bujnowski. Cynthia Jean Yezzi. Christine Marie Timon. Elizabeth Ellen Vahey. Gretchen Diane Evanoff. Sherry Ann Godecker. Sylvia Jean DeBow. Janet Ann Siebold. Marjorie Ann Teed, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Laura Marie Standcliffe. Diane Lynn Santamena, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Mary Lee Boniger, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Barbara Ann Malazzi. Audra Marie Sisti. Jennifer Louise Bull, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Ruth Ellen Mitchell. Elizabeth Ann Fessler. Sharon Marie Vandamia. Ashley Knight Goodrich, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, full four-year ROTC scholarship to Carnegie Mellon. Susan K. Razone, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Belinda Sue Pakella. Julie Ann Grippy. Nicole Ellen Miller. Marcy Michelle Metzger. Rebecca Fairbairn Gregory. Carol Marie Klecker, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $3,200 Athletic Scholarship, Gannon University, $1,000 Grant, Gannon University. Mary Grace Schickler, National Merit Finalist, $1,700 Academic Scholarship, Gannon University. Jennifer Carol Kuhn. Carrie Eileen Loftus. Mary Catherine Flanagan. Jennifer Mary Harding. Susan Marie Mink. Jacqueline Marie Brown, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Mary Ellen Dorothea Crawford. Judith Ann Barjelski, Presidential Academic Fitness Award, $1,500 President's Honor Award, John Carroll University. Patricia Ann Frontneck, Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Lisa Ann Zimmerman. Michelle Denise Carrick, $1,500 Academic Grant, Gannon University.
Bishop Murphy now presents the following special award. The Archbishop Gannon Award for Excellence is presented to the senior having the highest average over 4 years. This senior has demonstrated outstanding achievement in her academic studies and has grown in wisdom and grace as a result of her personal and educational interaction within Villa Maria Academy. our sincere congratulations to the outstanding honor graduate of 1985, Carolyn Maxwell. It is now my honor to present to you Bishop Michael Murphy.
Sister Moore, members of the staff and faculty, trustees, relatives and friends of the graduates and Villa Maria graduates of 1985. Each year I'm deeply impressed by the beauty of the Villa Maria commencement exercises, and I'm increasingly amazed at how something that is so spontaneous appears so well rehearsed. This year's graduating class enjoys the added distinction of being graduated during the year in which our diocese rejoices with the Sisters of St. Joseph over the 125 years of service that they have given to our diocese. As you can readily calculate from the fact that this is the 92nd Villa Maria commencement, the Sisters have been pioneers in education in this part of the country from the very beginning. We can't begin to express our indebtedness to them and to the very generous and dedicated lay women and lay men who in succeeding years have joined them in the enterprise of education, especially at Villa Maria Academy. I must confess a personal hope that the singular grace that may be given to the very talented graduates of this year's class may be the grace of recognizing that there is no professional career that attracts them now that they could not effectively fulfill within the scope also of the witness of religious life. It's my earnest prayer that as Almighty God has gifted them with charm and with talent, He will also give them that special sense of dedication that will make them willing to make those gifts and talents of service not only to an immediate family but to families upon families by religious life. I want to say a particular word of appreciation to the parents of the young people. Increasingly, the leadership in the church is asked to renew its commitment to Catholic education. And frankly, there is little that we can do by way of commitment to Catholic education unless that commitment exists in the minds and hearts of the laity. We can do all that we can by way of enlisting talented and generous religious and lay people to provide splendid programs of education from the elementary grades on through secondary education to the college level. But unless parents are sufficiently convinced that the education that's best suited to their young people is an education that combines value with information, those facilities will remain idle and relatively neglected. And that's why it's particularly important on an occasion such as this to acknowledge very sincerely the part that parents and families have played in providing the education that these young people are bringing to a successful accomplishment here tonight. And I'm sure that the graduates themselves would be happy to join me if the parents who are present here tonight and the representatives of the families who have made possible these high school years, they'd be kind enough to stand so that by our applause we might acknowledge the rightful share that they have in the honors of this evening. Would the parents please be kind enough to stand? Thank you. Thank you. I must confess that I was somewhat distracted during the commencement exercises, because earlier this evening I heard the word that you also heard about the tornadoes that have brought considerable destruction south, west, and east of us. And it struck me that that experience on the evening of your commencement probably more effectively than any message of mine brings home to all of us a very basic truth, and that is how fragilely held and tenderly held are the things that we value most, life itself. How dependent we are upon the day-by-day providential care of Almighty God, and how negligent we are in omitting the gratitude that we owe to Almighty God for the health and the life that we take so much for granted day after day. In those anxious hours from 5 o'clock on, neighbors of ours who might not have known each other that well suddenly came to realize how much they depended upon one another. And though they may not have been able to call one another by name, they didn't hesitate to call upon one another in their hour of need and be grateful for the need and for the assistance that was given to them. We pray that Almighty God may spare us any further suffering, that He may speedily restore those who have suffered serious injury or damage, and that the generosity and concern of our whole community will be a source of consolation to those who are the victims and of edification to the rest of us. For you graduates, I'm sure that a splendid education has been offered to you, and it's a little too early to tell to what degree you have benefited from these past 4 years. May I suggest that the value of these 4 years does not consist in what you know, but in who you know. And if you'd like to give yourself a quick quiz now to estimate how successful these 4 years at Villa Maria have been, I would suggest that you ask yourself these questions. How well do I know myself? How well do I know my parents? How well do I know the Lord Jesus Christ? Don't be surprised if you have to admit that you're still something of a mystery to yourself. In God's providence, it's altogether likely that you will remain a mystery to the very closing moments of your life. But you should be a little less of a mystery to yourself now than when you entered Villa 4 years ago. You should have a more realistic appreciation of your strengths and of your weaknesses. You should have a deeper appreciation of the fact that notwithstanding your weaknesses, you're the object of God's love and a singular expression of His creative power. How well do you know your parents? Hopefully, you've become aware not only of their weaknesses, as our weaknesses necessarily become manifest to one another in the close context of everyday life, but that you've come to have a growing appreciation of their strengths and respect for the fact that they themselves oftentimes are the first to admit there's something of a lag between the ideals to which they aspire and the performances of which they are capable. I hope you've come to know them well enough to realize that they hope that you will imitate the very best that is in them, and will fashion in your own life an amalgam of their strengths so that you may bring to your generation and the generations yet to come the very best that they have to offer. And how well do you know the Lord Jesus Christ? How much I pray that He's real to you. How much I pray that He's relevant to you. How much I pray that when with Pope John Paul II I tell you Jesus Christ is the only answer there is, You recognize the fact that this is not pulpit oratory, but simple fact. I hope a beginning in these three areas of personal knowledge has been given to you during these past years. And as I expressed the wish to you as you came forward, I hope that the years ahead will be filled with happiness and with joy and the fulfillment of your fondest dreams. I convey with my own best wishes the best wishes of Bishop Watson, and I take this occasion with him again to acknowledge our singular indebtedness to the Sisters of St. Joseph. And I would ask the graduates then if they would kindly stand that we might in prayer ask God's blessing upon them. Heavenly Father, we thank you first of all for the blessing of preservation by which you have spared us the suffering that has befallen some of our brothers and sisters, friends and neighbors. And for them we ask the blessing of consolation and protection and speedy assistance from those more fortunate than themselves. In the name of the graduates, I thank you for the blessings you have already given them, blessings of life and of charm, of grace and of faith. And in their name and for them, I pray that the years ahead of them may be filled with abundant manifestations of your love, the full flowering of the gifts of faith and hope and love that you've given them, and the most splendid achievements, in order that they may bring to the world something of that measure of justice and charity and peace that is your blessing for us all. All this we ask through Christ our Lord.
Yeah. Thank you.